Hello viewers, lot of parents come to consultation and seek advice from psychiatric doctors because the child is not performing well at school. In this YouTube segment, I am going to give you some guidance as to what you can do when your child is not academically bright. In terms of academic achievements, children fall into three categories. One is academically bright children. Second one is academically average achieving children. And the third type is poorly performing children. Now let's see what we can do with all these three categories of children and how to approach them. Let's look into the category of academically bright children. Being academically bright is just one good skill that a child possesses. If your child is bright in academic skills, it is well and good. But it is not adequate enough to achieve true success in their life. What parents should know is, a child should also learn a lot of good life skills in order to achieve true success in their life. For example, being a good communicator, developing good self-control. These are all examples of good life skills. Therefore, if a child is good in academic skills, parents should also encourage them to learn good life skills. Therefore, they can develop a positive personality and lead a successful life. Now, let's see what parents can do with an average performing child. If a child is not academic and performs on an average level, it is not their fault. It is okay to have average academic skills. First, parents should try to accept it. But remember, they can also achieve great success in their life. In fact, if you look into the history, many successful people were average performers during their school life in terms of their academic skills, but they still managed to achieve great success in their life. Some parents don't realize this and they shout at their children if they don't perform very well at school in terms of their academic areas. Being academically good is just one good trait that a person possesses. Sometimes some children may not have this good trait with them. It doesn't mean they cannot become successful in their life. It's just that they lack the interest in studying. Some parents also try to compare their children with other kids. If you do that repeatedly, it can affect your child's self-confidence and also self-esteem. In the long term, the child can also develop negative view about themselves and it can affect the child psychologically. So now the question is, what can you do in such situations if your child is performing on an average level? As parents and grandparents, please try to spend quality time with your child. Try to find out things that they are really good at. Each and every child is unique and they have some special skills and abilities they are really good at. For example, try to find out their aptitude for sports, music, artwork, etc. So every parent has got his responsibility and they should try to find out what their child's true passion is. So help them to develop their passion and encourage their skills in the long term. Also, when they become adults, they should be able to support them to make a living and get some income from their passion in life. They may be passionate about doing specific things. For example, some people have the ability to write short stories, but they can develop these skills and can become a successful author in the future. Some children are really good at handling electronic items. They disassemble the items and they reassemble it. So those kind of children can develop their skills in this area, and in the long term, they can become an expert or a technician in handling electrical and electronic items. on top of achieving these special skills, these children also should be helped to develop their good life skills, and therefore they can develop a good personality. This would help them achieve success in their life. Now let's see how we can help a below average performing child. If your child is performing poorly in their academic skills, it is important that you seek help from a clinical psychologist. A psychologist would be able to assess their intelligence level and give you a scoring. Most children would score anywhere between 90 to 110. If their IQ levels are normal between 90 to 110, then again you should not worry. Find out their passion and skills they possess and help them to achieve further in their life. Some children may have normal IQ, but they may have problems in specific areas like reading, which we call it as dyslexia, or writing, or mathematical calculations. Such children may need additional remedial training for reading as well as writing, and this can be done through special educators. It is important that your child is being assessed by a special educator. These special educators can identify their problems and help them to hone these skills. They help these children on an individual one-to-one basis, or they can also do small group teaching. We can also support them by providing a home tuition with special teachers who are experts in this area. If IQ is less than 70, please note that it is not their fault again. We identify and call these children as disabled child, or differently abled child, or special child. If they have problems in their IQ, like if it is less than 70, then we can find out if they needed special schooling, as many of these children can struggle to cope in secondary school. Such children will also need more help in the long term. Parents and teachers have to work with them in the long term to plan for their future. Government should also introduce some good schemes in order to support such children and their families with disabilities. Let me quickly summarize the points discussed in this podcast. If your child is academically bright, it is well and good. However, also teach them good life skills to develop a positive personality and achieve success in their life. If your child is performing on an average level at school, try to find out what their passion is. Help them to develop their passion. At the same time, they should also learn good life skills to achieve a positive personality and success in their life. Lastly, if your child is performing below average in terms of their academic skills, try to assess their IQ skills through a clinical psychologist. Some of these children may also need input from a special educator. Children who have IQ less than 70 may also need special schooling and long-term support from their parents. So after listening to this podcast, you should stop worrying if your child is not performing well at school. Don't lose your peace and happiness and make your child unhappy. Most importantly, child should enjoy at school and home environment and have a positive childhood. I hope that you found this podcast really useful. If you wanted such health-related information, please subscribe to our channel, Psychiatrist Prathap. Also press the bell button. You will receive regular notifications. Thank you for watching.